Today I'm going to give you my opinion about her poster, because a lot of emos blame each other for this on social media, and I personally hate this word, and I'm going to tell you why. First of all, I'm going to explain you what a poster is, because not all of you know what a poster is. The word poster in the emo subculture is a word used to describe fake emos. A lot of emos use this word, and it's to describe someone that's faking to be an emo and isn't a real emo but a fake emo, and that's a poser. I really get the chills when I hear people blame each other for this, and I really hate this word. And in this video I'm going to explain you why, because I actually think to call someone else a poser is really respectless, and I don't like it. I hate the word poser because I hate it to label people. I know what the emo subculture means and what it is, but I don't like it to label people and to be busy with you are fake and you are real. I don't like it. That's labeling. I just see everyone as people. I see emos as people. I see basic people as people. I see gothics as people. And I'm not the one who's deciding who you are. I know what the emo subculture is and means, but I'm not the one that's going to label someone else. I'm even surprised that there are people that like it to label people, and I don't understand why people do this, because I hate it to see someone and to decide what label I'm going to put on that person. It's not something I like. Like, you're a real emo and you are a fake emo. You are real and you are, I think, a gothic and you are a basic girl. That's not something I like to do, and that's labeling, and that is putting a label on someone, and that's not something I like to be busy with. Just see everyone as a person and just see everyone as people. If you call someone a poser, then actually I think you're busy with judging someone on his or her personality, if he's belonging to you, I think. And I actually think posers don't even exist. Well, let me explain you that. I'm not going to tell you that the emo subculture doesn't exist. The emo subculture exists, but I don't believe posers exist. The most emos that are new in the emo subculture are in the puberty phase. And when you're in your puberty phase, it means you're searching for your identity. It's a phase of your personality. And I personally think, how can you fake your personality? It's something that you're going through in life, and that's your phase in life, and you're searching for your identity. How can you fake that? Everyone in the puberty phase is searching for him or her personality, to search your identity. And that's how every emo becomes emo. You're searching for your identity, and everyone needs a chance to explore who they really are. And I personally think it's very respectless if you call someone that's searching for its personality, if you call that one fake and a poser. And I think someone is searching for its personality, how can you call that one a poser? I think that's so respectless. Why are you calling people fake if they are exploring themselves? And believe me, I have seen emos and they went through an emo phase, but if they aren't real and they don't find themselves in it, then this emo phase slowly goes away. And I've seen several girls go through this, and they slowly transform their style into something else, because these persons are searching for who they are and they're finding their identity. And if emo isn't their identity, then it goes away, and I've seen this myself. I know people that went through this. Something that's very important in the emo subculture is that you're not going to label people. I think emos don't like it to be labeled, and you don't must label other people too. So if you're an emo, don't label people. And if someone is new in the subculture and don't know what emo is, then help that person, but don't label that person. So, as an emo, I think it's really important to learn to people what the emo subculture is, but don't label people by yourself and don't label people as emo or poser. Don't be busy with who is a fake emo or a real emo. Don't be busy with it. Just learn other people and tell them what the emo subculture is, but don't judge by yourself. Well, okay, that was my new video. I hope I learned you something and I hope you think my opinion interesting. Well, that was my new video, so bye!